Hello.
Today
we're in a corner.
We are in a corner.
But
what are we doing today, Brant? It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
We are at the Kingdom of Magic, aka Disney's Magic Kingdom. And as everyone knows, it's its 50th anniversary, but we are not here to celebrate. Well, we're always celebrating that, and we will come back to celebrate that. But we are here for our yearly tradition of...
What is it, Brandon?
Hold on. Liberty Tree Tavern.
You got it.
I almost said Columbia Harbor House. And we are actually
that is
at the, like, the backside of water. We are literally, we're not literally in a corner. We're at the backside of Columbia Harbor, Liberty Tree Tavern.
Liberty Tree Tavern.
This has been really good. We've been doing this for 4 years now.
Yeah, like 4 years now we've done this as a tradition.
And if you want to explain why, or not why, but what it is and what we intend to get.
Yeah, so Liberty Tree Tavern, if you are not familiar with it, is a table service restaurant that serves family-style, Thanksgiving-style food. So it's like turkey and stuffing and mashed potatoes and pot roast and all sorts of fun stuff. And they have a really nice allergy-friendly menu. You can actually get gluten-free and dairy-free and allergy-friendly stuffing and gravy and potatoes, which is like really hard to get out. So we both really enjoy it. And
yeah, we do. I didn't think I would when we first came here because Sarah's been here before, long before we met each other and everything like that. But I don't think I'd ever been here before.
No, we skipped it for a long time because you didn't think you would like it.
Yeah, I mean...
And then he fell in love
with it. It's delicious.
It is delicious.
Even their mac and cheese, which is very kid-like and kind of... I want to be careful what I say. Sounds like, or looks like cheap mac and cheese. It's pretty good.
Although, I'm like, who remembers? I feel like Brandon right now. Who remembers when Stouffer's used to sponsor Liberty Tree Tavern? And they had Stouffer's mac and cheese. Also, even further back, who remembers when Liberty Tree Tavern was a character meal?
I've heard about it. I do remember that. I never went, but
yeah,
I remember that.
And had ham, which was delicious.
Ham.
This
is what we do every year around Thanksgiving, give or take a couple weeks or something like that.
Yeah, because we have family stuff, so we do kind of like a little dinner for ourselves that we don't have to make.
Yeah.
We get to enjoy here.
And it's really good. Very... Where are we at? We are in the...
Liberty Square.
Liberty Square.
It's very colonial.
Very colonial time period. Pilgrims.
Okay, that's not
I think you're like hundreds of years ago.
Okay, that's way further back.
Hold on, fact check us every now. We're gonna go, we're gonna eat, we're gonna experience it with you guys, and hopefully see Paul Revere and George Washington and
we'll be in their
rooms.
Be in
their
rooms.
Yeah,
themed.
The rooms are themed. Anyway, I'm thinking of all this stuff. I don't know.
We'll put a link to our vlog from last year. I think we were in the John Paul Jones room.
Yeah.
We were in the Betsy Ross room the year before.
Yeah, that was cool too.
Yeah,
all the rooms are very cool. Also, when you're in the, and we'll bring this up at the end, but when you're in these rooms in here, look around. They have a lot of cool stuff.
Yeah, they do.
You know, a lot of historical stuff. I know it's not real historical stuff, but it's really cool.
It is cool.
It is cool.
And it has good food.
Yeah.
And hopefully we'll see a little bit more of the holiday stuff. It is quite busy here in the park, so we probably didn't get a lot of like intro stuff, but hopefully we'll get a little bit more of the holiday things here too, because it's very festive.
Yeah. So ready to go. Say we're here and then hopefully go inside.
And have a pilgrim's feast, yes.
Let's see what we see. Plymouth Rock. All right, so we're here. I forget the name, but this is the Liberty Tree. Something, but it has 13 lanterns in it for the original 13 cars.
It does.
So very cool. Just wanted to point that out in case you're here and want to see something kind of cool.
History.
Alright, so we just saw the Rainy Day Cavalcade.
Uh-huh.
Something, it was awesome. I don't know if they just
Have you never seen that one?
Don't know if I've ever seen a cavalcade.
Yeah, we've seen some of the cavalcades.
Okay, but have you seen the Rainy Day Cavalcade?
I have.
On video or in
person? No, in person. Not very many times, but
Where
I have
Where was
seen
I?
It.
Maybe I've seen it, I don't know. But do they actually only do it when it's drizzling or rain? Because it is drizzling now, so I don't know if anyone can see it.
No,
but when can we check in?
In about 20 minutes.
Maybe a little earlier. Probably not.
Be
we got to be patient, but it is starting to drizzle. And watch this: if we ever panned up, No, but it is starting to drizzle, but about 20 minutes.
It's more than drizzling over there.
Oh, it's coming for us, everyone. We're about to get out of the rain. And
cavalcade was a,
it was a premonition.
It was a premonition. It was a
like Yoda says, premonition. Premonition, you say. All right, we're going to get undercover. We're going to get undercover.
Yeah.
Ready? Let's go. So we sat down and we talked to our server. His name is Ed. We actually got in the Fannie Mae room. And
Betsy Ross.
The Betsy.
Betsy Ross. Look back there. Betsy Ross. She made the flag.
Oh, the Betsy Ross. I said Fannie Mae.
That's chocolate.
Fannie Mae made the flag too. No, we're in the Betsy Ross room, which is awesome. It really is crowded, but if we have any time, we might get some video footage of around the room and everything. And we went over our allergies with Ed, our server. He was excellent. And now we just wait patiently, right?
Yes.
Yeah, trying to think. We ordered our drinks, unsweetened iced tea for Sarah, Coke for me. And yeah, we're really looking forward to this. Again, Ed was on it so far, and looking forward to the rest of the meal because, oh, they last year they actually had I'm allergic to cabbage. They had cabbage in the salad, so we asked about that. And there's no more cabbage in the salad. They changed the salad, right?
Yeah, he said that it's different.
Okay, cool. So we'll go over that when we get everything. But yeah, we're looking forward to it.
Okay, so salad's here, and it is definitely different than what we've gotten before. So it's a honey shallot dressing and some sort of masculine greens, so I'm going to give it a try. The dressing's usually really good. Nothing fancy, but it's very fresh. I like good. The vinaigrette. It's nice and light. I do wish they had the strawberry vinaigrette they used to have, but this is very good too. And yeah, just refreshing before you start your main meal of like very heavy food. So it's good.
All right, I'm ready to dig into.
Brandon, that's a everyone about a large amount of salad.
Everyone, hold on.
Help us.
Let's get a little less.
So while Brandon does that, we have our drinks and also got some regular rolls.
Yep, I'll try.
They're waiting. I'm going to be getting gluten free rolls. I'm just gonna not record you while you do. Oh boy.
Well.
So yeah, nice. It's the Sarah, what's it called? The topping?
The vinaigrette.
The vinaigrette. The sauce.
The sauce. Yeah, the vinaigrette.
That is delicious. It's nice. I mean this in a positive way. Nice generic salad, but it's a sauce that makes it delicious. That vinaigrette, really good. So I would be eating everything. All right, everyone, so I got the nice, normal, generic Disney rolls. They're mildly warm. I already know how they're going to taste, but let's have a bite.
And while Brandon does that, I did get my Bloomfield Farms rolls. They also have dairy-free butter, if you would like, or regular butter.
They're generic rolls. I'm not going to say they're bad. They're not great. But we don't come for the rolls here.
That's true.
At Liberty Tree Tavern. We come from the salad and everything after the salad. Rolls are kind of just... rolls, but this is solid.
Yeah, yeah, that's
solid.
Yeah.
What did we get?
Okay. So, true Thanksgiving feast. Turkey, there's stuffing under there. It's made with the Bloomfield Farms rolls.
Okay.
Pork, hot roast. We actually get gravy that's safe, more gravy, cranberry sauce, mashed potatoes, and corn.
And hold over here.
Oh, and this is mac and cheese. It is Amy's mac and cheese. Just a note about Amy's. I know many people are not comfortable with Amy's mac and cheese if they're gluten-free because there's a concern sometimes about cross-contamination. I've not gotten sick with it, so you know, you have to do what you're most comfortable with, but know that that is the brand. It's not a house-made mac and cheese. So I'm going to dig in. There's plenty of food.
What are you having first?
Stuffing, of course. Everything on here can be made gluten-free and dairy-free. I think the only thing that has dairy in it right now would be the potatoes. But everything else is marked gluten-free and dairy-free on the menu.
And that's the stuffing. There it is. Swing, swing, splash, splash.
Let me try the pot roast because this was our favorite last year.
Yeah, it really was delicious.
That's so
good. It's still so good.
Mm-hmm. One of the things that I like is, like, everything on this plate feels, quote, normal. Like, this is something you could get out. And it's completely safe for us. So, it's one that I just really love. Feels like the holidays. I didn't have to cook it.
Right?
Isn't it great? Cookie's fun. Okay. It's a little on the drier side.
We love the pork last year, too. Give that a whirl.
Good.
Pork is nice. I think the winners are going to be the pot roast, the stuffing, the green beans, and the potatoes. But it's a solid meal, and I just love that you can get something like this out at a restaurant, which is really hard to find. So we're going to dig in.
All right. Now it's my turn. Let's start with the most important part, the mac and cheese.
Of course.
Kind of hard to grab a hold of it.
And while Brandon is trying that, you can see his is very similar to mine.
Right, really good.
He just didn't get the stuffing and the turkey.
Okay, so let's have a bite, everyone, shall we?
Was the mac and cheese okay?
Mac and cheese, solid.
Just a generic.
Yeah, but it's really good.
Okay. Yeah, the pot roast, I think you're really going to love. It's so good,
yeah,
right?
There it is, I think this was the winner last year, if I remember.
Yes, it
and
was.
Sarah, I'm sorry. We'll link to that video from last year, but this was and is amazing. So I have one more bite.
You gotta try the potatoes too, and maybe the pork.
Let's do the pork first. All right, now for a quick bite of the pork. That's really good too.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, this is better.
Pot roast is the winner.
Pot roast is the winner.
You want to try a potato?
I do.
And then we're going to dig in.
Yes.
This is a mighty feast. Potatoes are good, right?
Feels like grandmother's cooking.
But,
absolutely delicious. Also, we didn't mention this is all you can eat, all you care to enjoy.
Yes.
So you can get refill or refills. Yeah, refills, I guess. But more if you want. We may not want, but it's more if you want.
Brandon, talk to me while you sad.
We got more food, and my noodles haven't come yet.
Okay. Well, you can ask for the noodles.
I'm going to ask for the noodles. No, we got fresh plates, and if Sarah pans down, there we go.
So this is our little tiny seconds, and they gave us a spoon, so we're going to make sure not to cross-contaminate.
Yep.
I got my thing stuffing separate. And hopefully Brandon gets noodles. If not, he'll be okay. You can ask.
No, I'm fine. Everyone, I'm so full right now. But we got more roast beef. Excuse me. More mac and cheese. More
potatoes.
Potatoes and more stuffing for Sarah. No, we're looking forward to it. We're going to not cross-contaminate.
And get dessert.
And we're going to get dessert in a little bit. But it has been outstanding. Thank you, Betsy.
Somebody already got his mac and cheese. Caught in the act. How was it, Brandon?
It's nice, generic, above average mac and cheese. And I feel very patriotic eating this mac and cheese.
Oh my gosh. Keep it joined. And I'm going to have my dessert. And I got, actually, it's a dairy-free vegan whipped cream that's on the vegan dessert.
Okay.
Because it normally comes with ice cream, and I did not want dairy ice cream because I don't do dairy ice cream. And it's just the generic pre-packaged brownie, so it's nothing fancy. So, it's not a fancy dessert, but probably tasty. It's heated.
Good, nice little dessert there.
Yeah, it was either this or sorbet.
All right.
I decided to go all out.
Cool.
It was fun. Yeah,
awesome.
Simple, easy.
Delicious.
Did you get more mac and cheese?
I got more iced mac and cheese. No, I got just some vanilla ice cream and chocolate sauce. Very basic, very good. And this is not dairy free.
No, but if you're gluten free, that could be an option if you don't want maybe a brownie or something.
Yeah, if you don't want a brownie or something, Sarah's right. If you're gluten free, but you can have dairy, or you like dairy, there you go.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'm going to dig in.
Brandon was not feeling any of the desserts in one sorbet. So we asked, and they said, sure, no problem. Consider the ice cream? What's happening?
It's vanilla ice cream with chocolate sauce.
But it's good.
I am a bicentennial baby, everyone. And it's delicious. All right, so odd debrief area. We have this amazing background that we are actually behind. We're at the TTC, and we are sitting behind one of the ticketing booth counters, guest service people. Mm-hmm. And it's weird. I feel like I'm sitting way forward. Forgive us. It's a quiet spot, the quietest spot we could find. Yeah. So, Sarah, go.
Well, we've said this a lot lately, that it was every time we go someplace, that it's kind of loud. And it was very loud in that restaurant. So, pro tip, the closed captioning is a great thing for accessibility and for when we are hard to understand. We're going to try to do better with the audio, and maybe I'll try to do some actual transcription, because the closed captioning that defaults is not always the best.
Yeah, we know if you follow.
I know it's loud.
If you follow our channel, you obviously think we're the highest caliber of YouTubers out there with the best equipment, like up there with Christopher Nolan and IMAX cameras. We're using our iPhones.
Yeah, we gotta try to figure out a better audio.
Yeah, we don't have cool little fuzzy microphones to put on. We wish we did, but other things come first. Right?
We do the best we can.
We do the best we can.
So sorry in advance. Belatedly.
If the audio is bad. But yeah, Sarah's right. The closed captioning on YouTube actually works fairly well. Again, it's automatic. We don't.
You can actually do audio transcription. I just need to go back and do that. So maybe that'll be a task for myself.
Background, in case anyone is new to the channel, you would think we both do all the editing. No. Sarah does all the editing. So if you like our videos, seriously, thank her for the editing.
If you don't like the videos, it's all Brandon.
It's me. If you like them, it's Sarah. And she started the whole channel 11 years ago.
It's like 12 years ago now.
12.
Oh, whoa. Long time.
Who knew?
Well, I started the vlog. The channel has been around less than that, but.
All right, we are going off on a tangent.
We sure are.
Which usually I do. So.
That was my bad. Anyways,
Liberty Tree Tavern.
So Liberty Tree Tavern is a place that I have a lot of nostalgia for. And now we have been going here for the last 4 years and made it a tradition. So that's been very exciting. Yeah. And it's just good home style food. I like that it's something that feels like you might not be able to get it out when you have a special dietary need, but you can.
Yeah.
Like gluten-free, dairy-free stuffing. What? So it's not the best. I would argue that I make better gluten-free, dairy-free stuffing at home. However, I did not have to make this stuffing. And
humble
it's still,
brag.
It was, but this was still, it's such a nice treat to be able to get that. I think if you're, going to Disney and you want something like that, it's a really great option. Like, where are you going to get gluten-free gravy? And gluten-free stuffing and all those kinds of things. It's just a really nice thing that they try to make it so that you feel like you're having the exact same thing everybody else is having at the restaurant, which is nice.
Yeah, they do an excellent job for both our issues that we have. And they fill you up. If you want more, you can get more. They work with you. And we're going to do a PSA upcoming on some dining issues we've had. But our server, Ed, tonight was outstanding.
He was awesome and really was very conscientious of our special dietary needs, making sure that we were okay, knowing a lot about the menu, which made us feel really comfortable. And of course, we could always talk to a chef at any time.
Yep.
We didn't tonight, but as Brandon said, that will lead into a video that we're going to be doing
soon. Wait on that. And that will be a very short couch video from home. Couch video. Little public service announcement from us to you. But be on the lookout for that.
And also, the other thing, too, again, because special dietary needs, some of the food that we get at Liberty Tree may be harder to get out, especially at the holiday time. I think this is such a great place to go to during the holiday season.
Yeah.
We go specifically right before Thanksgiving so that we can enjoy it as a couple and I don't have to make anything.
Yep.
And then, you know, it's just great for just all the November, December holiday seasons.
Yeah, it really is.
Which is really nice.
Yeah, and I don't know what more there is to say. Again, I'm sure if you have, if not, Sarah's linked to our video from last year and everything.
Yeah, but, which we tried to poison excellent. Brandon with cabbage.
Horrible. But it was so good. It's a great experience. The Betty Crocker room is amazing that we were sitting in. And
Betsy Ross.
But
the theme is great, and we didn't really talk a lot about that, but the theme is really fun.
Is a lot of fun. I am very big on wherever we eat. We kind of talked about this while eating. If we eat, I think they've closed it down now, sadly. But what's the place at Epcot in Morocco?
Oh, Restaurant Marrakesh.
Restaurant Marrakesh. While we're there, I want to learn about Moroccan history and stuff. And this is no different. Every place we eat, I eat at Disney, Sarah too. But I get big on, like, I'm sitting in there, I want to rekindle my love of American history and go back to school. And by go back to school, I mean do it for an hour, hour and a half inside the restaurant.
For us, we Wikipedia'd a bunch of stuff. Just because we were curious.
Yeah, it's fun. It's a lot of fun. And the restaurant, the theming's great and everything like that.
Mm-hmm.
Different rooms. Again, the Betsy Ross room. They have a George Washington room.
John Paul Jones.
We were in the John Paul Jones.
Because that was last year. We were so confused and we had to look everything up.
Because
he was an admiral.
Yeah,
we thought it was the George Washington room. But
it
was not.
Well, I don't know if I aced American history, we really love the restaurant. Hopefully some of our footage showed it. Excuse me, that was it. Hopefully we showed some of it. If you've been there, what do you think of it? Of course, leave a comment, talk to us in the comments below because we want to hear what you guys thought of it too.
Yeah.
Or think of it, or do you want to go there?
Mm-hmm. And I would definitely recommend it for anyone who's a special dietary who likes kind of Thanksgiving style food, because you really will get to enjoy a lot of nice stuff that you wouldn't get someplace else.
Yeah.
So I think it's a real nice treat because they have options for everybody.
Yeah, absolutely amazing. So anything, the 50th anniversary stuff. Quick, we're gonna make a quick aside. We are known, if you've seen a few videos ago, 6, 7, 8 months ago, we were not the biggest fans of the new castle. The new Cinderella Castle color.
I like the new update.
The salmon color. We were not fans of it until tonight when the 50th anniversary stuff they've added to it.
It looks much better.
So outstanding job, Disney.
Yeah, and all the holiday stuff.
All the holiday
really
stuff
awesome.
Is amazing. Yeah.
And then, of course, we saw more statues because we're trying to get all the statues in for the 50th.
Yeah, we haven't really talked about that. We just kind of sprinkle them in through the videos. But in case you don't know, there's 50 statues around all four parks for the 50th anniversary of Disney characters. And for us, we're finding them and inserting them randomly.
I feel like we got about 10 or 12 tonight.
We got a bunch. So anyway, that's all other topic. But Liberty Tree Tavern, amazing.
Yeah, so good. Great holiday stuff. It is a great way to start celebrating the holiday season.
Yeah, it's awesome. So do you have anything else?
No, I love Magic Kingdom during the holiday times. I love all the decorations and the decor.
She does.
And
she's
so
excited.
Nice to finally do it. And Brandon knows I love the holidays, so. Yeah.
And,
nice
we'll be back. We're hoping to come back sooner rather than later to have a Rego. Sounds like we didn't like it, but we've loved it. I want to do Skipper Cantina.
yeah, we were supposed to go do it, and then we had a family emergency, and we're not able to go to Skipper Tantooine. I have Star Wars on the brain.
Star Wars on the brain.
But we did not get to go to Skipper Canteen, so hopefully we'll get to do that soon.
So, yeah, but other than that,
I'm going to roll out of here.
We're going to roll out. So, but thank you to all the patrons on Patreon. Every single one of you is awesome. The subscribers, all of you are amazing. Thumbs up, hit the bell, leave a comment. I think that's it.
Yeah. If you want to see more holiday stuff, or if you have a specific holiday thing that you would like to see, let us know. We will do our best.
Can't promise it, but we will do our best.
Yes. So with that, we'll see you soon.
Bye.